Hi, in this lecture you will learn how to extract zip files. So in this directory here I have two zip files, items1.txt and items2.txt. Each of them have some CSV files inside. Now the purpose of the script that we're going to write is to put each of these file sets into two different folders inside the destination folder, which is currently empty. So by the end of this video, we're going to have two folders, items 1 and items 2, and each of those folders will have the corresponding files from each of these zip files. So we need the path object and the zip file library also. Root dir this time is going to be path. So guess what is the root directory? Where are we working on? I think it's the project directory, which is that. So a dot means it's in the same directory as the script. The script main.py is here in this directory. So that means we're working in the same directory. But let's also define the destination directory or path, whatever you like to call it. So this would be a path object also that points to this destination folder. And then you say for path in root dir.rglob, or should we use glob this time? So our glob would go inside each of the folders. But if you just want to check one level, so if you want to check this directory only, then you want to use glob, not our glob, because our glob would check the subfolders also. So .zip, we iterate to get access to these files, and we open each file using zip file dot zip file. So path, that one. This time should be read mode. We are not modifying these files. We're just reading them and seeing what they have inside. So that's a read operation. SZF, ZF is just a variable. And now we would say ZF.extract all. That's the method to extract the files. And this gets us a path argument. You see path here, it's an argument of this. And the path is equal to perhaps the destination path. So basically this should be a directory path, not a file path. This is a destination directory where the files should be extracted. And if we leave it like that, all the files will be extracted inside destination. But if you want to have separate folders for each of these, instead of putting them all in one folder, then you want to create a new path. Let's say final path is equal to destination path slash another path, which I would say could be something like path.stem. So path.stem path is this items1.zip, then it's items2.zip, and pystem gets only that first part without the extension, without the dot. So it gets only items1 as a string. So this is a string actually. So we construct a path using the destination path. So the product of this will be destination slash items1. In the first iteration, you can check that if you stop the script here, use this point and then go to debugger and press that run button. So you see now that path is here and stem is currently items, right? In that current iteration. So we're using the debugger to stop the execution of the script at the line where I placed the dot. So stop that, and yeah, that should do it, I think. But here now with path, path is equal to final path. Yeah, and run. See the destination. Yeah, so we have these two directories, items one. These are the files that were inside items1.zip and items two. These are the files that were inside items2.zip. And that's the final code. Let me delete that breakpoint, and I hope to see you in the next videos. See you.